This is Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandy. Today, Senator John DeFrancisco is here to talk about how taking advantage of education opportunities today will make for a brighter tomorrow. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Good. You know, it's hard to figure out really what the best choices are. Kids have a lot of trouble these days. Well, they always do. But, you know, it's to try to use good judgment. We've talked a lot on this program about some exceptional kids in your district who are doing really great things and the parents who volunteer to mm-hmm. help move them along the way. Tell us about, you know, there are certain bills to help try to make kids safer, cyberbullying being one of them. I know the Senate was a champion on that.
You know, what I try to do in this business as far as children are concerned, first of all, you've got to have laws that are sufficient to protect children who are being bullied or being harassed or being assaulted or whatever it might be. Those that are doing the assaults and the bullying should be either prosecuted or disciplined in some serious way. And on the other hand, when children do the right things and are showing that they are leaders, that they are responsible for themselves, they're successful, that we got to encourage those students as well. So that we could hopefully encourage good behavior and get rid of bad behavior. So, and that's part of what this is all about. Some of the bills we passed, the cyberbullying bill, was a bill that basically increases punishment, tries to protect children by providing blocking devices in order that certain bullying cannot be continued in libraries or whatever it might be. But the point is trying to make sure that where the law has to change, like when we're in this new electronic age, the statutes will change. So we passed the bill to punish that sort of activity, and it should be. Because nobody should be harassed to the extent children are being harassed at this point in time electronically. So if you're going to do it, you're going to be punished or you're going to be prosecuted.
Yeah, a good way to keep up with the trends. And you said, you know, to make sure you commend the students who are doing well. You actually stood up in session the other day and talked to some valedictorians who are working hard and who will be graduating soon. Let's take a listen to that.
In our chamber, we pass a lot of bills all the time that deal with problems in society. And dealing with the problem, are they all on this side? I don't
both
know.
Sides.
Both sides. I'll keep going like this then. We pass a lot of bills dealing with problems in society, whether they be individuals that get into criminal trouble, whether it be people who have not succeeded for whatever reason. And it occupies so much of our time. But we have to recognize, and this is why it's so great what Senator Banasek does, is that there are good kids, responsible young people that are doing the right thing, working hard to succeed, because responsibility for yourself is the most important part of succeeding in life. Well, you've done the right thing so far. You got a long way to go. If you keep up the drive that you've shown up to this point in time, you are going to be the future leaders of our society. And believe me, we need future leaders. So thank you, Senator Banasek, for allowing us to pause for this thought, which is an important one, and congratulate all of you for your success to date and for your success that we all know you're going to have in the future.
And just like you talk about, you know, staying competitive with other states in jobs, it's also the same thing applies to education.
There's no question about it. I think the key to good education, in my mind, is to challenge the students and just don't accept mediocrity. I mean, the children or young people are going to go as far as you push them to do. Some are self-motivated, some aren't. But just to make it easier or just to ignore the lack of progress, that's just unacceptable.
Right. And, you know, making college affordable, you have talked about that, making it affordable, as well as, you know, having incentives to keep the students in New York after they've graduated.
Yeah, absolutely. If the college affordability, we've passed a bill which provides for different techniques to try to make it more affordable, whether it be less expensive loans, whether it be abilities to obtain jobs while you're going to school. It's a whole series of things. More state aid to the colleges to make it more affordable. We got to make college education affordable in order for everybody to be able to participate that has the capability of doing it. Not everybody should be going to college.
Right.
It's just unreasonable to assume that. Mm-hmm. There should be trade options at the community colleges or at technical schools. But those that want to go should never be prevented from going by not having enough funding. And one of the things that I've been working on recently since the last budget is we found out that the SUNY schools spend up to $90 million a year remediating or teaching students what they should have learned when they're in high school. Mm-hmm. So last week I had a meeting with the chancellor of SUNY, the chancellor of CUNY, the commissioner of education, and several deputies from each of those areas, trying to figure out what we can do to turn that trend around so the students are prepared. And one of the ideas that I had come up with, they seemed to like, and we're exploring it. It seems pretty logical, and you know, it's not rocket science. I mean, I think someone should have thought of it before. But if you're taking the test to determine whether you're capable of doing college work, and you take it when you get into college, and then you spend the first year of educating the students what they should have learned before, and then you go back to high school, and the Commissioner of Education admitted this. He said, I used to teach high school, and some kids get done with their credits, or they're taking study halls, or they're going on a job in their senior year. What? And then some are not qualified, you go to college. Mm-hmm. So why not take that test at the end of the junior year, beginning of the senior year? Mm-hmm. Provide those remediation courses so the colleges aren't spending that kind of money and wasting money on something that should have been done earlier. And second, the students aren't wasting the money by paying for credits in college when that should have been something they got for free in the undergrad. So we're trying to work on all of these things, and that will help make college more affordable as well.
Yeah, that seems like a good plan for everyone.
I would think so, and yeah. Hopefully we can get that done.
Yeah, good idea. You know, the other week we talked about Mr. Pennison. He was a science teacher in your district. He won the Horace Mann Award, and it was really exciting. He was in Washington, and now here on the screen is Principal of the Year from Solvay Middle School.
Yes, James Werbeck with his wife, and he is an incredible principal. And he became the high school middle school principal of the year, and which is one heck of an honor statewide. So we've got good teachers, we've got good administrators in Central New York, and there's good and bad in every profession, including the political life.
Yes.
And so we've got to encourage, just like I said with the students, we've got to encourage the ones that are the best. And we got to make sure that the ones that aren't are performing the way they should be performing.
Yeah, and that's a really good thing that's happening right now with the education reform and taking a look at everything and kind of just weeding things out.
That's correct, and hopefully we're moving in the right direction.
Yeah. You also recently got together with the music educator of the ward.
Yes. Yes, this is Joe Raposo. Joe and I are good friends. He plays the saxophone. I try to play the saxophone. And every time I see him, I say, we see eye to eye. And that's literally, we see eye to eye. And one of the few people that I'm not shorter than in all of these photographs. But he's an incredible musician. He used to teach music. He was a band instructor at Liverpool High School in the Liverpool district, and then he's followed by Jim Spadafore. Ironically, this was at a Spadafore event, his last performance as a conductor, and Mr. Spadafore followed in his footsteps, and he's now retiring. So there's two generations of incredible honorees who Joe Raposo has been honored nationwide for composition, for Educator of the Year. I mean, this man is unbelievable. We have a jazz festival in Syracuse. Several years ago, part of the jazz festival was that there was a Catholic mass, and it was called a jazz mass because instead of the folk music that I think we've had enough of since the, since the 60s or whenever it was, we had a jazz mass, and he performed a composition that he did for his mother when his mother passed away. It was so moving. It was just absolutely beautiful. And as a result, I'm a big fan of his. And he's won the Educator of the Year Award for the Sammys. That's like in Syracuse. We have those awards as well, Syracuse Area Music Awards. And great guy, great talent. And as I said, you've got to make sure those who would do the great things are recognized.
Another really smart, creative, talented kid we've talked about. We showed his poster, the Earth Day poster winner from your district. And now we have a picture of him and with his family and teacher.
Yes, this young man, Dayton Diabo, he is a Native American. And I didn't understand the photo, how he ended up, or the poster, how he ended up with a turtle and the globe on it. Mm-hmm. Well, he explained, as a Native American, the turtle is very important. There's a turtle clan in his nation. And he thought of his heritage as well as something that would give the message that, the environment is extremely important. As you know, it is with Native Americans more than any. Of our citizens, and what a well-spoken young man. I mean, he was polite, he was articulate, and just he was excited about having won, and so was his grandfather who was with him. And that school, by the way, was my grammar school. It's gotten a lot older since I went there. It's kind of, but they're keeping it up well. But he got a kick out of the fact that I went to the same grammar school. So once again, kids that are doing the right thing, keep them encouraged to keep going in that direction.
Yeah, I remember when we showed the poster, you were wondering, you were like, I wonder what the turtle is about.
Yeah,
interesting.
I didn't know. And that's how important he felt, because the turtle is important in his heritage, that's why he did it.
Fantastic. I want to hear more about the Central New York United Power Soccer Club. This is pretty amazing.
Yes, this group of young and not so young people, a couple are in their 20s. This is a power soccer. They do it in their chairs. And I went out there. I was invited to go to one of their practices because I was helping one of the young people, trying to get through the bureaucracy to get a chair ordered. The state was supposed to get to him, but it was taken forever. So that's how I got to know the family, and they were extremely happy. Now we're well on the way. It should be resolved very, very quickly. That she should be getting the chair. So they said, would you come out and see our power soccer team? Now, too bad this wasn't an action photo. These people run, go in forward and reverse at top speeds. Mm-hmm. They wanted me to try, and I declined. It was too dangerous for me. But and they are so good that they cannot get games locally. So I think they go somewhere in the Midwest. They're going to the Midwest.
Yeah, Indianapolis.
Indianapolis to participate in these events. And you got to give a lot of credit to the parents and the supporters, because that's quite an effort to get the whole team from here to Indianapolis. It's not like just boarding a plane, because they have their equipment, et cetera. And it's good people doing wonderful, wonderful things.
Right. So that will be in July. So we'll take a look at your website in about a month, defrancisco.nysenate.gov. I'm sure you'll have an update on that.
And they will win. There's no question about it. They will win.
Great. Thanks so much for being with us, Senator.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. For any additional information, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.